comes down to this last match. India throughout this series has been behind England, chasing their tail, whether it be the test match that they drew, the one-day format where England won 2-1, or even this T20 matches where they lost the first one. England can still win the series, but can India draw it? It's time for the preview of the final T20 match here on Cricbuzz. Probably the biggest highlight from this series, for me personally, is to be able to actually sit back whilst I'm here in Australia and watch every single match of these two teams go head to head. Before, it was all about following live scores, live streams, maybe a radio broadcast, but not to have the wonderful quality that we've seen through the broadcast of Sky Cricket. So I'm a little bit sad, to be honest, that this is going to be the final match of this multi-format series between England versus India. India will certainly be high on confidence. I mean, look at the emotion and jubilation that they had once they were able to secure their last victory against England. It did bring about and stopped England's run of 12 T20 international wins in a row. And also, can you believe it? The last time India won a T20 in England was 2006. Yep, 2006, which is such a long time ago. There were some great signs for India in the last match. Shefali Verma was able to put to bed a few demons of Catherine Brunt steaming in, managing to hit her for five boundaries in one over. Harmanpreet Kaur looked good in that No. 3 position, and I hope that she stays there despite whether India lose an early wicket. I think your best batter needs to spend the most time out in the middle, and that's Harmanpreet Kaur. And she gave us some glimpses, so I'm hoping she feels a little bit more comfortable and confident. I think also the toss is going to be really important. If India set, they look a better side. They haven't got the scoreboard pressure. They can actually make the running of the match. It's almost going back to old school cricket, where you used to prefer to put the runs on the board and let the scoreboard pressure and your bowlers really chime in. Given the fact that India takes so much pace off and their spinners are really effective when they're defending a total, why not give them that opportunity again? If England win the toss, I don't know if they will put India in. I guess we'll have to wait and see. So my playing 11 for India in this final match: Smriti Mandana, Shefali Verma up the top. Harmanpreet Kaur, please elevate and stay at No. 3 regardless of the situation, which means Harleen Diol does not fit into the playing 11. I think India needs some better strikers within the middle to late order, and I don't think Harleen Diol can do that. Someone that I would like to see in that No. 4 position is Indrani Roy. It's a perfect opportunity to see a fresh face that we haven't seen in Indian colours. She is the leading run scorer within the 50 over domestic competition. So she comes in with a bit of form, with a bit of confidence. Give her a chance. Then you've got Dipti Sharma at 5. You've got Sneh Rana at 6. Now, Arundhati Reddy, the last two T20s that she's played, she has gone for over 10 runs per over. So I don't know whether it's worth giving someone like a Pooja Vastrika a chance to come in. And the player we haven't seen so far this series is Simran Badur. Now, my father tells me Badur equals brave, so maybe just throw her in, hey, and see what happens. She did play the three T20s against South Africa. Okay figures. So it might be worth giving her an opportunity. Then you've got Shikha Pandey, who, whilst she didn't perform as well as she would have liked in the last game, I think she needs to give an opportunity again. Poonam Yadav certainly will come in, but Radha Yadav looked like she had the yips, really struggled to get the ball out of her hands. I don't know what training has been like for her since that last fixture. There is someone sitting on the sideline that can do exactly her role, Ekta Bish. Whether India will bring her in. You get a sense that India may not want to change their playing 11 given that they won the last fixture, but I think they can make some little tweaks to get the best out of their group. As for England, yes, they would be bitterly disappointed that they didn't win that last game. Some poor shot selections, some luck going India's way with the run out of Heather Knight, but I don't think they'll make many changes. Like I said, I think England have outplayed India throughout this whole series, but India have fought back every time. So England will be disappointed that they still haven't won the series and we're down to the last game. So the only change that potentially they could bring in is Freya Davies. While she hasn't gone for a lot of runs, I don't know if she's got the impact that they would like. We've got Anya Shrubsole that's sitting on the sidelines. I don't know if there's a workload management or injury concern around her, or Tash Farron, but I would certainly go with Anya Shrubsole. They need to win this last fixture, so why not bring in your best 11? And I think Anya Shrubsole, if she's fit, she's your best 11. Right, the key battle for me, and we've seen it throughout the series, and why not one last time, Shefali Verma versus Catherine Brunt. I've absolutely loved it. But there's also been another battle that has also emerged, and that's Shefali Verma versus Sophie Eccleston. Now, the last T20 match, Sophie Eccleston bowled a maiden to Shefali Verma in the power play. Can you believe it? A maiden in the power play. So watch out for that little battle. Shefali Verma is full of entertainment and she's facing some of the best bowlers in the world. So look out for that battle. My prediction, I actually think it's going to come down to the toss. I feel like if India win the toss and they elect to bat, they may get a bit more confident. And if they're able to post something in the vicinity of that 150 mark, their spinners may come into their own. The only issue for India is this final match is at Chelmsford. Now, it used to be the fortress. England had never lost a game. It wasn't until Meg Lanning was able to smash, I think, 120-odd at Chelmsford to break that cycle. But it is a ground that England know and love. I know I'm sitting on the fence a little bit. I do think England will come across and win this final match and win the series. But I am absolutely going to be glued. I hope you will be as well, because this series has given us so much entertainment. It's been great to see both teams go head to head. And I look forward to seeing you on the other side when we do the review, and also maybe my ratings on the white ball format.